one of them up, I guess.
Any one of them?
Yeah.
Oh. This picture was taken in the year 2000. It was the last family picture that we had taken before anybody got married. This is Amanda, Michael, Stephen, Bethany, David, Joshua, Elizabeth, Jordan, and Alicia. Oh, I'm sorry. And my husband, Dennis, and here am I. So this was in 2000, and so that was 6 years before I was diagnosed with cancer. As time went on, flowers became more important. It kind of took the place of taking vacations like I would like to, because my cancer and my treatments and the changes that they brought limits me from going away. I just can't always leave the house when I'd like to. Kind of justify how many flowers I have because it's my vacation. I was diagnosed in 2006. With rectal cancer, and I never would have expected that. So I had chemo, I'm not even sure how many periods of time, and I had radiation like 3 or 4 periods of time every day. In 2011, I metastasized to my liver. There were times where I knew that if God was not holding me, I would let go, because I didn't have what it took. But when you go through something like this, you realize how totally dependent you are and have always been. The only way to get through this is that God holds on to us. A couple of years ago, I was in church and I was sitting in a sermon, and the pastor said that we can always be sure of whatever we go through, that God is with us. And I remember sitting there thinking, that's not enough. But it's enough. That now that it is. And there have been countless times where I had to go back to chemo after having a little break, and I would dread it. And I would be given a piece. God would orchestrate amazing details, people that I would meet, it would just be incredible. Countless assurances that God was there with me, He had gone ahead of me, He was around me, alongside me, and He had prepared all kinds of things to happen to make me realize that I didn't have to be scared. One of the things that I've hoped for a long time that my husband and I could do is I thought we could go on short-term missions. And because there are things he's really good at that would make that a great experience, and there are things that I'm good at that would make that a good experience, and we could, you know, be helpful somewhere. But that maybe won't be. I have found out the medical community considers me treatable, not curable. Because it just keeps coming back and coming back. It's in my liver, and I've even had doctors say, you have this long, or well, maybe this long to live, or whatever. A greater miracle is that God, instead of healing us, makes us happy. I'm accepting that more. There's an old quote, courage is fear that has said her prayers. And it's true. That's the biggest thing for me, as far as my family goes, is that they keep right on living with me. That to me is courage. And I think that my family has been wonderful that way. I have hard days and difficult days, but every day there are moments of laughter and joy, and that's a gift from God. So in a sense, some people would say, Holly's dying, you know, because I'm not curable, but I'm living.